He knows a lot about the science stuff. Professor Dave explains.
So for this practice problem, we're going to be looking at energy diagrams. Energy diagrams are very important for understanding the thermodynamics and the kinetics of a reaction. So what we want to be able to do is we're going to draw an energy diagram for a two-step reaction that is exothermic overall and has a first step that is a rate-determining step. So see if you can draw an energy diagram that fulfills all those criteria. Now I've gone ahead and drawn an energy diagram that does fit these criteria, so let's remind ourselves a couple of things about energy diagrams. Number one, on the y-axis here we have potential energy, so potential energy increases going up, and then we're always moving forwards in time this way, so this is the reaction coordinate, we're going forwards in time. So we have our reactants and we have our products, and then we must have an intermediate because this is a two-step reaction. So this is two discrete steps, which means we need two slopes like that. Now, first of all, we said it's exothermic. So what that means is that, or actually let's do that. what that means is that the delta H must be negative. That means that from reactants to products, it must release energy, it must go lower in energy. So the first thing that must be true about your energy diagram is that the products must sit lower than the reactants on the energy diagram. That is how we make sure that it is exothermic overall. Now, the second thing that we have to understand is that this is a two-step reaction, so there has to be, first of all, two discrete steps, and each step has its own activation energy. So right here, we have the activation energy EA1, and that is the activation energy required to get to transition state 1. So for any reaction, we're going to have an activation barrier that has to be overcome to reach the transition state, after which point it certainly will continue to completion. So there's transition state 1. So we're starting from the reactants, transition state, activation energy, and then we get to this intermediate. And then right here, this is going to be activation energy 2 and transition state 2. And now, when we say that the first step has to be the rate determining step, what has to be true about your energy diagram must therefore then be that EA1 must be greater than EA2. Because in solution, things are swimming around, and in terms of kinetics, a larger activation barrier means that molecules must collide with a greater amount of kinetic energy. So the bigger the activation energy is, the more often that collisions will not result in a reaction. You can have them collide with this much kinetic energy, they don't go. A little more, they don't go. A little more, they don't go. Only when they collide with enough kinetic energy to get over that very large barrier do they go ahead and generate the intermediate. And so the larger the activation energy, the slower it's going to go, because it's going to take longer for enough collisions to occur for all of the molecules to react. So on the macroscopic scale, what that ends up meaning is that the reaction with the largest activation energy is going to be the slowest step and therefore the rate determining step. Once we reach this intermediate right there, this relatively much smaller activation energy 2 is going to mean that so many more collisions will result in a reaction. So once they get finally above this one, they're very quickly going to go ahead and undergo the second reaction to generate products. So two-step reaction means we need two humps like that. Exothermic means the products must sit lower than the reactants, and then the first step being the rate determining step means that EA1 must be greater than EA2. Thanks for watching, guys. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.